So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new team review video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with the club from Ukraine. It's Shakhtar Donetsk. I get a few requests during this FIFA year to do a review about this team, and yeah, after a couple of requests I was checking out this team and I thought, well, let's give it a try. I tried a few formations with lots of different players, and I think this is the best formation and lineup you can use. Also, the tactics and the instructions are important as always, so make sure you will watch the whole video and set everything the same up like I did if you want to try it out yourself, of course. And let me know in the comments if you tried it out what your results are and what you think of it. I'm really curious about that as always. But before we begin, I really want to ask you to drop a like under the video. It would be really helpful if you will do that. You can also subscribe to my channel, of course. I'm doing lots of tactic videos, tutorial videos, all kind of FIFA 21 videos. So if you're interested, make sure you hit that subscribe button and you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. All right, gonna start with the formation. It's a 4-2-3-1 narrow formation. Then we're going to the lineup. Pjatov is the goalkeeper. Dodo, the right defender, Bondar and Matvienko are the center backs, and Ismaili is the left defender. Now we have two central defensive midfielders, Stepanenko and Marcos Antonio. Stepanenko is the most defensive one and Marcos Antonio is the most attacking one. Then we have three attacking midfielders. Tete is the one at the right side, Moraes is the central one, and Marlos is the left one. I'm using Marlos at the left side because he is left-footed, and Moraes is right-footed. And yeah, also his skill moves from Marlos are 5-star, so that's pretty good to have on the side of the field. I really like to have that on the side of the field. And yeah, if I must choose between him in the center or on the side of the field, that's why I'm using him on the left side. Dyson is the striker, and I know his possession is not striker, and I know Moraes is a striker, but I use Dyson because of his pace. He has 92 pace, which is really fast in this game. And yeah, his shooting is okay, his passing is okay, his dribbling is really good, skill moves 4-star. So for my feeling, he is the best player in this squad to use as a striker. And Moraes, yeah, his dribbling is okay, his shooting is good, his pace is not bad, but he's not fast also, so that's why I like to use him on the central attacking midfield, and Dyson as a striker. And as you already saw at the beginning of the video, I'm showing you the guys, the goals that I scored that was in Division 2. And yeah, he scored, I think, 4 goals, so almost all on his pace. So that's why I'm using him as a striker. All right, let's go to the tactics. I choose balanced with a width of 4 bars and a depth of 4 bars. Offensive style also balanced with a width of 7 bars, players in the box 5 bars, corners and free kicks both 3 bars. Then we're going to the instructions. Pjatov is just default goalkeeper. Then we have Dodo, I choose stay back while attacking. Bondar and Matvienko are just default, and Ismaili also stay back while attacking like the right defender. Then I already said Stepanenko is the most defensive midfielder, so stay back while attacking for him and cover center. Then we have Marcos Antonio. He's the most attacking one. He has the high work rate, so he's going forward a bit by himself. So I use balanced attack. The only thing I change for him is cover center. Then we're going to the right attacking midfielder. Get into the box for the cross. The same for Moraes. Get into the box for the cross. And Marlos, get into the box for the cross. Then we have Tyson. Stay central and get in behind them. With this instruction, he is making these lovely runs. You saw it in the beginning of the video, scoring these goals with his pace, with his runs. So this one is really, really important for this formation. All right, then we have some substitutes as well. We have some good substitutes because Solomon, 81 pace and dribbling is good, so you can replace him during the match on an attacking midfielder possession. I would recommend you to put him on the left and on the right side. We also have this guy. I don't know really his name, but it's Konoplyanka. I hope I'm saying this name right. He is also a good one to replace Moraes. We have Kovalenko. He is also pretty good. You can replace him by one of the central defensive midfielders or as the central attacking midfielder. We have Alain Patrick. I use him to replace Stepanenko almost all the times because Stepanenko getting tired. And yeah, to have a fresh central defensive midfielder with the pace of 75, it's a wonderful thing to have on the bench. The goalkeeper is not that important, of course. The center back is just there, but I never used him. And then we have Fernando. He has 86 pace, so he is a really, really important substitute to have. You can replace him for one of these three, for Tete, Morales, or Marlos, and you have a really fast attacking midfielder. You can also replace him for the striker, but his shooting is not that good. You only need him for his pace to make the runs. When your opponent is already tired in the 70 minutes or whatever, you can replace him by Marlos. Put him on the left side, let him make the runs, and yeah, get your benefits out of that with this pace. And Tyson also in front, so you can counterattack really good with these two guys at the end of the match. All right. That was it for this video. I really want to thank you very much for watching, of course. Please, if you didn't drop a like yet, I really appreciate it if you will still do that. And hopefully we will see you next time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.